was some hopped-up gringo a long way from home, making trouble the only way I knew. As the weather worsened, I caught a glimpse of the rusted shells of previous lives that had been lived out here in this swampy shithole, and I wondered if I would end up the same way, or what would happen to that girl I was supposed to protect. I had no idea what lay ahead. And as much as part of me would rather be anywhere else, I knew this was where I had to be. I felt responsible. I just had to fix the situation, right here. I couldn't understand them, but I didn't have to. Cheap hoods are the same from here to Timbuktu. The slab of meat on the boat was clearly the boss. Serrano, they called him. And it seemed that our suspicions were correct. Fabiana was here, somewhere further ahead. I had to find her quickly and quietly if possible. Last thing I wanted was a party with these clowns. Moving toward the signs of life, rubbing them out as I went along. I'd seen enough to know that Fabiana was at least alive, if not exactly well. Her captors didn't look like they were quite the kind and gentle type. I had to find that room quickly.
Sim, cara, para de mentira.
Vai Caralho. Se fuder, cara!
Vai tomar no meio do cu!
Eu vou te meter bala, hein?
Vá se fuder, porra!
Oi! Dani! Você tá aí? Você tem um cigarro?
Video feed now. Just my own imminent cameo. I had to keep moving. I hoped that I'd find Fabiana sooner than later, if at all. miss them. She was on the move. If they'd finally decided to kill her, I wasn't doing anything to persuade them otherwise.
Porra! Cala a boca! Ninguém pode te ouvir, caralho! Sua burguesinha safada! Vou te pegar, é? Vou te pegar antes que eu bote uma bala na tua cabeça!
There she was, right in front of me. The drunk fool in me wanted to make a play.
Puta! Vamos!
But I had just about enough sense to know that I'd end up with another dead girl in my arms if I did.
Não, velho, não. O irmão já falou, velho, ele quer inteira.
Aí, você vai jogar dinheiro no lixo, hein?
Caralho, cara, tá virando uma cilada essa porra, mano.
Serrano had taken Fabiana through the garage door. I had to find a way to open it. It seemed Serrano's boys had targeted the entire Bronco family and didn't give a shit which one they pinched. I opened the door to the next circle of this low-rent hell.